Let's start. First, I'll introduce myself. Then I'll take your introduction technically. After that, we'll move towards technical introduction of the courseware, what exactly it is, and how we can take this entire training forward. And then we'll start our agenda for the day. So I'll introduce myself first. My name is Vimal Singh, and I'm a Microsoft certified trainer since 2008. Since that time, I'm associated with Microsoft Technologies in terms of training delivery and consultancy for the various, you can say, technologies for the different organizations. If I talk about my technical training delivery, so I do deliver training for on-prem infrastructure that includes server, identity, federation, and definitely identity automation is also their main theme. Apart from that, the way industry moved towards the virtualization, so I also deal with this virtualization technology that comes from Microsoft, which is Hyper-V, and the system-centered products that helps us to create private cloud and everything, system-centered virtual machine manager, system-centered configuration manager. Apart from that, as industry moved towards the public cloud and we got Azure from the Microsoft side, so I also associated with this technology and to deliver training for the Microsoft Azure. That includes all the infrastructure related trainings, AZ-104, AZ-303, 304, solution architecting, DevOps 500, migration for SAP workloads. Apart from that, I also deal with security products like SC-900, SC-200, SC-300, AZ-500. And definitely for hybrid as well. So I used to deliver Azure Stack, and recently that Microsoft has updated a lot of things about the hybrid cloud and private cloud. Now they are calling it Azure Stack Hub. And there are many Azure Stacks, HCI, Azure Stacks. So I do deliver training for these products as well. So these are the technology for that I do deliver trainings. Apart from that, as far as this consultancy concerns, so I have done some projects related with migration. So the migration was something related with web application, which was running on private or on-premises infrastructure. I migrated it to Azure Cloud. Apart from that, infrastructure as a services, I created on-prem data center infrastructure and migrated this entire data center infrastructure over the cloud. And now things are running from the cloud. So these are the projects I have already done with Microsoft Azure Cloud. This particular training has been designed for 24 hours, means 3 working days, today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow. This would be 8 hours training, in which definitely we are going to plan or will do bifurcation, where there would be some part which we'll be discussing theoretically. There would be demonstration, and we will have dedicated lab time. So you will execute these hands-on exercises to get more confident for this product, on this product. This training is slightly different from other training of Microsoft, as it contains a lot of execution. It has a lot of exercises that we need to execute to have understanding of this product. So I'll help you at what exactly, how much time you need to spend of doing hands-on exercises. But before going there, let me just start. This is the welcome slide, not the technical slide. This welcome slide is from Microsoft, which is welcoming you for this particular training. This is one of the official training. And the trainer, those who are delivering this training, in your scenario, I'm delivering this training. So only Microsoft certified trainer can do this. So I'm the one who is Microsoft certified trainer for this particular session. We already gone through the introduction. So while having this 8-hour long session per day, as I said, we are going to define the break times and everything. We are in the online session, so definitely not all the bullets are required for us, but definitely we'll start every day our training at this time. And I believe it is 9 a.m. for you, correct? You're sitting in which time zone?
Yes, I'm sitting in Singapore time zone. It's 9 a.m. for me.
Correct. So every day training will start at 9 and it will get binded at 5 p.m. And in between, we will have breaks. Maybe around 10:30 or 11 o'clock, we'll have one tea break or body stretch break. So you can take a rest for 15 minutes. After that, around 1 o'clock, depends on the discussion, 12:30 or 1 o'clock, we'll decide. We'll have lunch break. And post that, majorly, we will have hands-on execution. So again, we can plan our breaks accordingly. The rest of the thing, as it seems, it would be one-on-one session, like you and me, because we were expecting some other participant as well, but no one has joined so far. So seems it would be one-on-one session. So we can have our mutual understanding to meet other bullets like phones, messages. It depends on how important these calls are. You can take it. Now, so here, the person who's should attend this training, have understanding of Windows Server Administration, configuration, maintenance, on-premises environment, hybrid environment. So the person, those who are having this role, can find themselves comfortable with this course. As you already mentioned that you are from Unix background, so that's not a big deal. I'll try to make you understand all this part, and then we'll take this entire session forward. So it says the audience, the candidate who attend this course typically are IT professionals who manage on-premises Windows Server environment, Microsoft Azure, want to run their virtual workload on Azure, Windows Server 2019, medium to large scale using software-defined data center and hyper-converged principles, and want to use existing Microsoft System Center products to implement managed software-defined data center with Windows Server 2019. So from these bullets, we just came to know this is something for the professional, those who are already familiar and working with Microsoft products. And this particular training will help them to go for hybrid or hyper-converged infrastructure. So we'll be coming on that point, what exactly it is, and how can we use this. These are the prerequisites. So the participant must have the operating system information, the idea what exactly it is. I believe you have not got a chance to work with this operating system, but you know what exactly these things are. Am I correct, Cheng?
One way to another, I can understand what the items is all about. Let me see. Except the part on implementing and managing infrastructure as a service in the Azure stack. So that is the portion that I may not have the experience with.
Okay. But rest of the thing you heard about, right?
The rest of the thing, I heard about it.
Okay, that's fine. So I'll give you some introduction about this part and make you understand this as well. And even you're not familiar with this in terms of hands-on with these bullets like Windows Server Operating System, their virtualization, Azure AD, or the PowerShell scripting or PowerShell DSC, or maybe the Microsoft Compute Storage Networking, Windows server-based compute, or virtualization-related technologies. So I will give you the introduction of everything that you will understand, and then you will utilize everything in your stack, Azure stack. So what I will do is, because it's instructor-led training, and the good thing, it's one-on-one training, you and me are sitting here. So I'll try to change the, you can say, sequence of the training. First, I'll make you understand all this prerequisite, and then I'll take you on the course content. Will it be fine for you?
Oh, that's perfect.
And so now this particular training contains four modules. And this starts with the module number one, which is introducing Azure Stack HCI. So while having the discussion of module one, I'll try to accommodate all this prerequisite content. I'll give you the understanding of everything, the reason, logical approach to use cases of it, everything. And then we'll try to understand this particular what. After that, module number two is operating and maintaining Azure Stack HCI. So once we'll get understanding what exactly Azure Stack HCI is, then we'll move to understand how can we operate this HCI. Once this infrastructure got created, how will maintain that infrastructure or Azure Stack HCI. Then module number three is planning for and implementing Azure Stack HCI storage. So when we say Azure Stack HCI, there are few major components we have for that, like storage, networking, and their operating system. So operating and maintaining will give you the understanding of the infrastructure of it, operating system of it. But these are two major components we have under this Azure Stack HCI that we are going to explore in module number three and module number four. So module number three would be majorly focused on storage, and module number four would be majorly focused on networking. We have module number one, but before going to this module number one, we have to understand this prerequisite that we discuss, what exactly these things are. So let me make you understand this point, and then we'll move towards the stack discussion. So let's talk about infrastructure. Like I said, what you understand with infrastructure. If I talk about digital infrastructure, a digital infrastructure is something that helps you to run your digital applications. Like, for example, one of the organization needs web application, and they have web application. So this application is what? It's just a code someone has written. Now from where this code will keep running, so for that definitely we are having something called infrastructure. So you will have server, you will have database, I would say database. Now you need to plan how this authentication will take place, means if someone is trying to access this application, there must be something who can identify that person, that who you are, and then provide the application. So you will have something called maybe Active Directory. Then you thought like how this communication will take place, how this server will talk with this one, how this server will talk with this one. So you will plan something called networking. Means there would be switch. That you will connect to. So all these can talk with this each other, they are connected. Now there would be possibility that you have users and these users are sitting somewhere in your private network where the systems are also connected to the switch. So they can easily access the resource and the application. There would be possibility that the user is sitting somewhere in a public network and they want to have access on it. So you must have connectivity from here to public. So this entire thing is known as what? Infrastructure. So now, what is the traditional approach? Definitely, we have to plan a lot of things at this place. This is one instance we have created. You may have multiple applications. So you need to create some more infrastructure for it. You have different services for that you need to create. You have different locations. For that you need to create infrastructure. So it seems like, for example, you have two different locations. One is Singapore. All the ASEAN, you can say, location is being served from this particular service or this infrastructure. And you have customer coming from European location, Europe location. So you thought like a similar infrastructure we should have somewhere in a Europe location. Now you thought like, okay, we have something in US location and they have a lot of customers. So we thought like creating US location. So we created similar infrastructure in Asia, Europe, US. Now we also plan disaster recovery. If something goes wrong in Asia location, then automatically the traffic should get redirected here. And things should work from here. And maybe from here, everything is getting replicated. Things are identical and working fine. Now, think about the cost. Think about the administration, management. Will it be simple? Will it be cost effective? Or it would be costly? If we are going to plan such infrastructure?
I would say it should be costly because we have three different data centers, three different locations, the license, to power the machines and all that. That will actually cost about the cooling and everything.
Right.